Hello, welcome to Chattcast. This playing. Is your host, Mode Blue.
Okay. So, as
you know, such a beautiful voice.
As you know, unless you just start on episode 4 because reasons, we just picked up Boone as a companion, and that means we're pretty much broken for the rest of the game. Which is good.
When I played through this, I never really used companions, because it's like, when I first played through it, someone had told me that if they died, they'd stay dead permanently, so I just never
used them.
That's
Fallout 3.
Yeah.
In New Vegas, they only stay dead permanently if you're on hardcore mode.
Well, that's kind of good, because I played through hardcore mode recently then.
Dustin, I think you need to get a new laptop screen. Yours seems a bit cracked.
Yeah.
It's got bullet holes, because that's how glasses break, you know?
Exactly.
Okay.
They're very hardcore glasses.
I forget what we're supposed to be doing right now.
Wait, is your guy a Cyclops since it's, like, a single lens?
Yeah. Okay.
Or, sorry, is your girl? My bad.
Yeah. Quit being sexist. Okay. Let's see. Oh, yeah, we're supposed to ask...
Find the man who tried to kill you.
Yeah, we're supposed to try and find the people that killed us, and to do that, we go and talk to...
This door.
Manny Vargas.
Oh. Why don't you talk to the door? He'll know.
Yeah, you know, that's very
true. The door
true.
Always knows. Do you think I should turn off this effect? Like, do you think it's cool or do you think it's shit, guys?
Oh, how long does it stay? Is it like that permanently?
Yeah, that's like, well, except on things like this.
I don't know.
Okay.
I guess we'll just skip through everything Manny's saying. Who's Boone?
Yeah, he doesn't matter.
Where's Rachel?
Where's Rachel?
Okay, so this is Manny. He's the other sniper in this town. And basically... He knows about the dude that shot us, but he's being a jerk and he's making us go do a mission for him before he'll tell us what's up. And I'm going to try and find this mod real quick and disable it. Okay.
So Dustin, you edit this, right?
I do.
Well, if this is a spoiler, it's up to you to sort of, if you don't want this spoiled, to if someone hasn't played this in however many odd years it's been out.
Uh-huh.
Isn't Manny, like, didn't he have something to do with selling Boone's wife? If I remember correctly, it's been a while since I played it.
I don't think. Maybe?
It's been quite a while since I played it.
I know he didn't like Boone's wife, but
yeah.
I don't think he had anything to do with selling her. I think that was all Jenny May.
Yeah, that's the chick at the in the main hotel room, right?
Yeah, she's the one whose head went.
I wasn't in this episode, sadly.
Oh, yeah,
you
weren't watching it either. Watch it before this episode comes out.
Was that. Which one was that? That wasn't Wasteland Diplomacy, was it?
That was Wasteland Diplomacy.
Oh, I've watched Wasteland Diplomacy.
Yeah, remember at the very
end? Yeah, because that's where we go on the rant about how the black keys aren't good.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Spencer's not here to defend them this time.
You mean every single video?
Wait, what video?
I think this is secretly just the We Hate Black Keys concert.
I was really concerned where that was going for a second, Josh.
I wasn't.
And that's all
Eddie, not being concerned about racism. Kudos to you.
Well, Eddie's known me for... Whoa. Dude, whoa.
And that's why we like Boone.
You shot him dead.
I didn't shoot him.
Boone shot him dead.
Free stuff.
Bop caps, yeah.
Did he just shoot that for you?
Yeah. His companion and he sniped
shit. Boone's a sniper, so pretty much he can pretty much destroy things before I'm even aware that they're there.
Yeah.
They're there.
I think that stop sign made fun of your mom. No, Dustin, don't.
Oh, God,
he's
Dustin.
He's dead now.
Every freaking time.
Dude, I mean, we had to settle that stop sign with Wasteland Diplomacy,
well,
you
Dustin,
know?
Well, Dustin, what you don't understand is stop signs are impervious to bullets.
Bullets are impervious to stop signs.
No, that created a paradox.
It's like a immovable force hits an unchangeable object.
Does that mean it just can't change, like, its shape and everything?
Yeah.
So it's not a wonder
it's
twin?
Okay. It can still be
moved.
Oh, okay.
But the
immovable object can't be moved. So
well, the force is unmovable, so...
The unmovable force the unchangeable object.
The force is midichlorians.
Exactly.
I don't like this conversation anymore.
I don't think you liked it to begin with.
No, it's just the midichlorians.
Guys, this game reminds me...
The midichlorians are the powerhouse of the cell. That's what I learned in middle school. Oh shit, there's a lot of them!
Oh my gosh, Dustin, you're... Oh.
Okay, Boone. Boone, this is why I got you. Shoot
Does
them.
Manny make you go, yeah, the Repcon site, that's where all of the other ghouls are and the human that thinks he's a ghoul, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I've...
Yeah, Brad Pitt.
Like recently? I don't remember.
Is that you?
I shot that last one. Boone shot the other three.
Boone is like a fed cat carrying him through this game.
Ah.
I don't get the reference.
Picture like
yeah,
Garfield.
TLDR.
Bazooka.
Yeah, TLDR.
I thought that was Teemo.
Kind of.
Yeah. Well, I mean, if Teemo gets fed...
Well, with the bazooka, that's PTSD Teemo.
it'd be Omega more like Tristana. Omega Squad. Yeah. Right? If you're watching this for some weird reason right now,
What do you mean for some weird reason? We're the funniest Let's Players on the planet.
Oh, we named two Let's Players at the beginning of this, which is probably getting cut, that are funnier than we are.
Riot, please don't ban us for saying this, but make an Omega Squad Tristana.
And while you're at it, can you unban Dunky?
Yeah, we really like that.
Yeah, that's this open letter to Rito Pliss.
Rito Pliss. Rito Pliss, unban Dunky.
But yeah, to put it into perspective, Dustin, Cat has the skill that you could, like the skill cap that you could go 0-19 in like the first 20 minutes, and by the end of the game, you could be 31-19.
All right.
That's kill deaths.
Yeah, kill deaths.
No assist because you're Cat. You don't give a fuck about your team.
Yeah.
Don't care.
Tell me again.
See, now you're becoming Cat. Good job.
Oh.
Tell me again.
Keep telling me. Tell me. Tell me. Where's the detonator? Where's Rachel? Where's the bomb? Okay, I'm cutting this bit real... Oh, wait, never mind. Something's about to attack me, so I'm... Well, yeah. I'm cutting this bit, but I've already decided what I'm naming this episode. It's going to be called A League of Their Own.
Why not 10,000 Leagues Under the Sea?
Maybe.
10,000 Leagues Under
the Sea. I like how he's sniping in the middle of a building.
10,000 Leagues Under the Sea. You were thinking. This man is thinking.
Thinking is for nerds. Whoa. Let's beat up
Eddie.
I bet
you wore glasses. Nerd.
Oh, start, God, I don't. Nerds.
To start beating up Eddie in the middle of the video.
Josh, do you wear contacts or glasses?
No.
Yes.
No, you don't.
I know. I lied.
You're one of our few friends that does not have eye problems.
I don't have any. No, I don't. Not at all. It's one of those few things that I never really thought about, and now that I think about it, everyone else that I know has glasses.
Yeah.
And or contacts.
Every single one of my roommates last year had eye problems.
Really?
Yeah.
That's funny. Well, not funny in the sense that it's funny.
But funny in like the, oh, that's kind of odd, kind of funny.
Yeah.
But,
it's funny because they're blind.
I don't like Helen Keller. Please cut this.
No, we need to make the reference for people to go check out.
That breaks the Chattcast motto. You know how,
Which one of our, like,
the Greyjoy, the Greyjoy motto is, we do not sow, like, because they don't plant or anything, they just fight. The Chattcast motto is, we do not edit.
You know, that is kind of true. But, that was really shitty, because I had, like, perfect, well, I might say perfect vision, but I had a really good vision up until, like...
The Fire Nation attacked?
Yes, actually. They print Zuko'd me, and I've got, like, a burn on my, like, left eye, and...
He actually is kind of cool. Like, he's kind of neat. Kind of BA, not gonna lie.
Yeah.
I never got to see, like, the very...
I put my penis in him.
Like, I saw most of, like, The Earthbender stuff came right before the Fire Nation stuff, didn't it?
Yeah, it was Earth, Fire.
Yeah, I saw most of, like, the...
Or WEF, for short.
Yeah, I saw most of the Earth Nation stuff, but didn't get to see a lot of the firebending stuff, and...
I think I saw about halfway through the Earth.
Yeah. I picked up, I saw like most of the second half of the Fire Nation, but didn't get to see like the finale when all of the shit goes down.
This is the ugliest ghoul I've ever seen, guys. Look at him.
He's beautiful.
Look at this ugly guy.
Stop I'm ghoul shaming.
Dustin, you're looking in a mirror, dude. Like, play the freaking game.
Bruh. This is the game.
I lost the game. Is that the first time that's happened on Chattcast?
Problem?
No, second time.
Damn. Hey, four viewers out there, you just lost the game.
We have like two, Julian and one of the people at the desk out there. I don't remember, I don't know which one it is.
Do we count as our own viewers?
Do we?
No.
He looks beautiful.
Okay, so...
I think Josh is just sort of awestruck by his appearance.
So, Mr. Jason Bright is leader of these ghouls that Manny wants us to get rid of. We could easily just whip out our shotguns and just blow them all to Kingdom Come.
You know, I've never thought I'd do that.
But he's also willing to leave. Like, he's trying to leave, but there's a bunch of demons, as he put it, outside, or in the bottom of this building.
Outside.
And there's... Not outside, but...
Yeah, I know.
At the outside of the bottom.
I just said outside.
Oh, boy. I hope they're not, like, the racist demons.
They're probably the racist demons.
So, during D&D last night... Dustin's character, like...
Okay, so... My character in D&D picked up an assault rifle that does bonus damage when I'm racist.
Because it's like, he tried to pick it up, and, like, since, of course, D&D is supposed to take place in the past, it's like, people were being brought to us from the future via portal guns, which Dustin now has.
Yeah,
and,
beautiful.
And he tried to pick it up and ended up shooting himself in the foot.
No, I shot you in the foot.
Yeah, he shot me, like, through the shin and through the calf. forgot about that, yeah, because that led to me not being able to do certain things, which I'll explain to Josh later. But,
yeah, let's not talk about that one in the video.
Old Jim doesn't need to be talked about ever.
I don't know if I want you to tell me about Jim later. I think I'm good for that one.
But, yeah.
But,
so, I'm a paladin, so, you know, I know shit about religion and stuff. So, I pick up this assault rifle. I'm like, can I use my knowledge of religion to channel, like, Southeast American Christianity and figure out how to use this thing?
And
I got, like, a perfect score on that.
On a nat 20?
Yeah, a nat 20 on a 20-sided dice, which means that I just rolled a 20 on the 20-sided die.
DM has no choice but to give him everything.
Yeah, so I immediately knew how to use this gun, and plus, since I channeled Southeastern American Christianity, I did +5 against people not of my skin color. So there was that.
That's...
I'm not surprised.
That's horrible. I don't know how to feel about this, Dustin.
I mean...
Sergey, what do you think about these?
I think that the only way to aptly describe it is how they say in America, "Dah!"
Yeah, of course, of course.
Of course, of course.
How could they be so foolish? Oh no, it's the demon! Oh crap, he's big.
Okay, so this is the demon, Davison. He is a Nightkin, which is like a super mutant that
turns
invisible and they're blue. Wait, what?
Why can't he be a banana muffinkin?
What's
is it because you're the only remaining banana muffinkin, Dustin?
I am the last banana muffinkin. But anyways, a lot of the Nightkin are schizophrenic, and this guy thinks that this cow skull right there, I'm not sure if you can see my mouse,
it's a Brahmin skull.
That one.
I'll steal that cow skull.
Boone just murdered someone?
I thought that was you that died.
Oh, yeah.
I thought it was too. I was like, how'd I die from walking? But yeah, he thinks this skull is alive, and it's his voice of reason.
Oh, kind of like Wallace's voice of reason. I'm gonna make like... I can already tell I'm gonna make several D&D references in this video that they don't get.
We could, but we could also solve things... You see,
diplomatically.
He was complaining about Harland here, who got trapped here when the Nightkin first arrived, and just pretty much waged war on them and started slaughtering them. And now he's trapped here, just killing Nightkin if they come at him. So the Nightkin can't leave because Harlan won't let them leave. This guy's fucking with me.
Oh shit. Wait, did you just kill that guy?
Yeah. It wasn't Davidson. He's strangely okay with me murdering his people most of the time.
Probably because Antler's okay with it. Antler's the real OG. He's the top.
Yeah,
Antler's... I heard Antler went to Stanford.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's actually pretty good. Like, I was surprised because he only had like a 28 super scored on his ACT.
Did he get into their medical school? Because I heard Sergey and Tim actually got shafted from their medical school.
They really did, and it was kind of aggravating. He was very upset with that.
Shaft? Yeah. That's like my favorite superhero. There's so many of them. Jesus Christ, stop.
You didn't bring your OG sniper with you. Whoa, he does not care about those bullets.
Nope.
Aren't there clubs called like rebar clubs?
Yeah, they're rebar.
Lost an arm. Rhubarb, I think you mean.
Yeah.
Dustin, you lost an arm.
Well,
do you guys want to get something to eat after this?
Yes. I'm pretty hungry.
I actually just ate before this, so I'll probably just...
Well, I mean, we're going to be recording for like an hour.
Inserting you
when
you're here.
Oh. Yeah, pretty much. Like, it. Alright, for those really dedicated fans,
let's
not. Around.
Let's not.
He just got done eating Chinese food.
But yeah.
Indian.
So...
I had Indian food, actually. It's really good. In Texas, I had it. It was pretty good.
Really, yeah. It depends on where you eat it. I like the one around here because I just really like curry. And that's not, like, racist at all, I promise. I just really...
Why would liking curry be racist?
I don't know. You find ways to make things racist.
Yeah. From the high school I went to, people find ways to make everything racist. And ironically, it's the racist people that do that.
Oh, yeah.
Just like Eddie.
But, anyways. Back to this game.
Oh, yes, of course.
Harland, the ghoul that's shooting... the Harlem Globetrotters want us to go check on their girl ghoul friend thing person.
Georgina.
Yeah, Georgina.
Florida.
And they want us, like, if we find them, or if we find this ghoul girl and make sure she's okay, everything will be fine. And I can't focus on what I'm saying because these two behind me won't shut the fuck up.
I bet he's uncircumcised.
What the fuck? What the fuck are you two? What? No.
Maybe if you were a dedicated Chattcast fan, you'd know they're just referencing the circumcision simulator game they were playing last week.
Yeah. It's part of Ash Rangers.
Circumcision.
Circumcision.
Circumcision simulator.
I wonder if you have to give a circumcision and surgeon simulator, because then that'd be a really good title for an episode.
I'm pretty sure you don't.
I'll put that down in my...
You never know.
Book of
crap.
So is mods.
Yes. There might be a circumcision mod. Won't lie.
So Dustin.
So there's an invisible nightkin who has a key, and I'm supposed to be killing him, but I actually cannot find him.
He's usually up, your brightness is really hard. Well, you just said. Holy shit.
Yeah, this is a dark area.
Yeah, like, are you? No, like actually in game.
Effort. Okay. Well,
isn't he usually up like through there?
Yeah, he's usually right there. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, he turned it all the way up.
No. Right. Turning it all the way up makes it look terrible. That looks pretty good, right?
Slightly better.
I guess it's really just here. This area. Yeah,
that's the angle I was looking at it too. I felt like a lot of the things we talk about on Chattcast are things like the viewers can't like it's things the viewers can't see a lot of the time because of course the brightness is gonna be meh to them, and then the angle I was at is sort of making it darker too.
So he's an invisible nightkin.
Yeah, and he's also just not here, which is kind of annoying.
Have you checked your backpack? Backpack?
I'm pretty sure I do not have people in my backpack.
I do.
You never know.
Yes.
I mean, I keep a handful.
Oh, speaking of like D&D things that I said I was going to reference that no one else except Dustin gets.
Yes.
I'm carrying a 95-pound woman with 30 pounds of 95-pound woman with 30 pounds of gold jewelry on her in my backpack.
Oh, that's beautiful. Yes. She has a third of her weight in gold.
Yeah.
That sounds kind of like Dustin.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure it's actually 45 pounds, so she has half her weight in gold.
Is it 45 pounds?
I think so.
Yeah, because she's 35 pounds total. So yeah,
okay,
or
40
pounds,
dude.
There's the rhubarb club. We're moving to the hallway.
Can we just
now.
Like speed this up and put the Benny Hill music here?
Yeah, this is probably going to be where we cut a lot.
I was about to say, if we don't speed this up and Benny Hill music isn't here, here you go.
Is Benny Hill related to Hank Hill?
Damn it, Benny!
Does that mean Benny, like the guy that killed you, related to?
He didn't kill me. He just shot me in the head. No hard feelings.
Dude, look at this.
He killed your aspirations. Like all you wanted in life was to deliver that package on time.
Yeah, we could probably sleep with him.
That's disgusting.
Yeah, this is true.
Like you can actually sleep with him in this game instead of murdering him. Well, you can kill him in his sleep, which is nice.
That's impressive, is what that is.
What?
You want to tell what you just saw?
Yeah,
yes,
Eddie
okay.
just showed me the most amazing headline ever.
I have to PBR radio this. Okay, so according to a headline that Eddie just showed us, a man, did it say the area he got arrested? I'm assuming Florida, because a lot of things like this happen in Florida.
I don't think I've ever heard of anything like this.
Okay, no, it doesn't say.
Let's just assume it's a Florida man, although we're not entirely sure
you know
the location.
Make of us couch.
I feel like it's a safe assumption, though, at the same time. Continue, though, Mike.
Yes. But a man got arrested with 30 eyeballs inside of his anal cavity, which Josh said was disgusting. I said was very impressive, and then Dustin just said, "What?"
That is exactly what I said. I was like, "What?" Okay, so the jailer isn't spawning, so you know,
maybe he already sniped him.
You know that's true.
If he sniped him, his body would appear because bodies don't.
Yeah, I was gonna say if he sniped him, then
what if the jailer was like upstairs though, and he sniped him as he were.
That's not the.
He always spawns down here.
Yeah, he always spawns down there. I don't know what's up with it.
Does he always spawn?
Check and make sure I'm at the right part.
I was gonna say, does he always spawn like specifically in that room?
Yeah, I've never had him not.
Spawn. Search the nearby room for stealth boy.
Get rid of the nightkin in the basement. Oh wait, maybe I probably fucked up and didn't. Get Harlan to tell me what to do. I probably didn't do the right audio cue.
It's fine. What you can do is you can just like skip all that, do the PBR radio thing, and then.
Huh. Well, Harlan's not speaking to me, so I'm assuming I did do it.
Was he there?
I didn't see him, but he has to be in there, right?
Look up there. Does he like move around up there at all?
I don't know.
Shoot the barrel.
Wait, doesn't he make a break for it anyway? Like, at some point? Or is it after you kill the jailer?
Oh, he's dead. Okay.
I mean, I guess that works.
I guess that works.
Thanks, Boone, who I'm assuming shot him.
I mean, if Boone shot him, we probably would have gotten the trigger. Maybe, I wasn't paying attention to what I was saying. Maybe I accidentally instigated him instead of working with him.
This is true. So, do you still need the jailer's key? Since you have Boone's key? Well, I would assume so, yeah. One thing I've noticed that I'm terrible at in this game is hacking terminals.
Okay, so basically what that thing told us was the shipment of stealth boys, which is what turns you invisible, that the Night Ken are here for, isn't here. They fucked up.
Now you fucked up.
Now you fucked up.
What is that from?
I don't know.
I know that. Every time we say that, it's like, I know it's from something, but I don't remember what it's from.
SpongeBob.
Probably.
That was a really intense episode of SpongeBob.
Yeah, that was.
I got a key off of Harlan, which makes me assume Harlan has stuff, but I don't know where it is. Oh, shit. Okay. Good thing those, for some reason, did literally no damage to me.
Yeah, I mean, I know
Oh, shit. That did damage to me.
At least your head's not crippled.
Oh, I'm out of stim packs.
Do you have any doctor's bags?
Nope. Let's see what we have that I can heal with. This is an experience, guys.
Here's some dirty water.
Gross.
Okay, cool. We're gonna
use
that.
Sounds like the water that comes out of the faucet here.
Yep, pretty much.
Oh no, I forgot. One of the mods I have makes it so that food doesn't restore health. That's really unfortunate.
How did you get that mod?
Because it's just part of the mod pack. Fucking, I know Harlan did a thing. Now, where's the thing? God damn it.
Now, Dustin, now you know how I feel in DLC quest, except...
We need to find a bonfire. I don't want to lose all our souls.
Okay, let's see. That's just a toolbox. Yeah, nothing cool in there.
But yes, now
damn it, I want his cool stuff, guys.
Now you know how I felt in the DLC quest, knowing no direction what to go in, except now you sort of remember what to do. It's just not working out the way you planned.
I mean, I know what to do, but yeah. I'm too stubborn to go do it because I want his stuff. Wow. Like,
this is true.
I think this is going to kill our viewers, Justin.
You could always come back later and
do stuff. Viewers are going to kill us, Josh.
Our viewers, Julian wouldn't kill us, and then I don't know. Eddie, you still haven't told us the name of the... guy at the desk that watches our stuff.
I don't actually know his name. I love him.
Wow.
I don't know his name. I feel bad. I can go ask him afterwards.
We like you guys. Thank you for watching our stuff, but we definitely don't know your name.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Pretty cool.
Maybe it's over here. I promise, God. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to leave, guys. I don't want you to have to watch this for the rest of your lives.
If only I was the same way as DLC Quest.
I'm unbelievably confused by the... Oh, cool, he just turned... Okay. I think this happens when we accidentally kill every one of his people.
Aren't you supposed to kill every one of his people?
Well, usually we can just, like, get him to leave peacefully.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I'm about to leave in peacefully. Yes. That was lucky.
Pokemon.
Do you have cool
stick.
Things for me? I don't care about that. The real foe has been slain.
Oh, no.
See, now you just upset Antler.
No, we have defeated Antler.
Antler wasn't even in the form of that skull anymore.
No. Antler is now the form of you.
Yes.
Okay. So there's only one way to defeat him, Dustin. I think you know what it is.
Seppuku. Seppuku.
Isn't that one chick from the anime?
No, you're thinking of Sudoku.
Yes, you're right. I apologize.
Was it James that always used to say Sudoku? Or was it one of my other friends?
It's someone we know.
I think it was James that always used to say commit Sudoku.
Is that the jailer right there?
That's the... I don't know what to say to this, guys. I don't know what to say to
now, this. Assuming that things go the way I think they're going to, here is a peaceful PBR radio voice for calming Dustin down, because I'm pretty sure he's about to have a mental explosion.
Eh.
How could this happen to me?
How could this happen to...
Sorry. Happen to who?
I avoided copyright. I think I'm debuffed right now because I'm super fucking slow. I think my strength is really down. Why am I moving so slow?
You're over
in here. Oh, fucking caps lock.
Josh, do you know what I found out that's going to be a bitch to edit Surgeon Sim?
What's that?
Like, when we were recording the sync, either A, it's like, didn't record the exact sync. Or I think it's like when we did it, it sort of like glitched too fast together, so I have to sort of find a rough estimation
for it. Oh my god, this is gonna be beautiful.
Running backwards.
No, it's like we sort of narrate what we're doing the entire time, so yeah. That's good.
Yeah.
Oh.
If anything, I'll steal this video and I'll just release all of the audio over this video.
You could do that. Oh, no, that's not the person. No, oh, there he is.
Can we steal his suit?
The demons are gone.
It's a nice suit.
Okay.
I am Morgan Freeman, and I approve this game.
Imagine what Morgan Freeman and Markiplier's love child would sound like.
What the hell is a projectile?
Probably just like... God, he'd be... It's Gilbert Gottfried.
Yeah, you're right. It would probably sound like God.
No, Gilbert.
Well, no, Morgan Freeman was God, and was it Evan Almighty?
Yeah, he was.
Bruce Almighty. I think both, actually, but...
Yeah. I never saw Bruce Almighty.
Bruce Almighty was the one that I found humorous.
Both of them were alright.
I think Bruce Almighty was pretty good, and Evan Almighty was alright.
Yeah.
Whoa, he has, like, a spaceman
helmet on. All of these... Here's the, fucking Grandmaster plan of...
Oh, they're gonna say Grandmaster Yi. I was like, no, not Yi.
No more Yi.
I'm not ready.
This is the Grandmaster plan of the ghouls. They think that their, like, promised land is the moon. Because I guess ghouls don't need oxygen to survive. So they're just all going to go to the moon where people can't be dicks to them. Which kind of sounds like a good plan. I'd do it.
Can we do that?
Sure. Chattcast on the moon?
Yeah.
Is that another motto?
No.
Or is that just our aspiration?
Can our new motto be no more mottos, please?
No.
What's our motto after that? If
we lie.
Psych more mottos.
Yeah, I was supposed to say, if this is your first video, or if we haven't...
I psych ward mottos.
Same thing. Or if we just have not mentioned as much, we have a running list of Chattcast mottos. When I say running list, I mean we just keep saying them and haven't really kept track of them. But we're up to like, would you say it's about 13 mottos now?
I think we have 14 with the Pokemon theme song.
Oh yeah, the entirety.
The entirety of the Pokemon.
And then, well, the first half, and then it's the motto that came after that was, nobody knows this half of the Pokemon theme song.
Pretty much, yeah. Eddie, you've been kind of quiet. You have any thing to input?
Eddie's not in this video, Josh. That's how that works.
Oh, who am I talking to then?
I mean, Eddie's in the room, but we do three people on a video.
Yeah, so. Dumbass.
Wait, I thought we did like five people on a video.
No, we try to avoid that because then it just turns into hell.
I thought it whatever.
Okay, so
you learn when you're older, Josh.
I know. For all of those viewers out there who have been wondering how old we are, Dustin is 19, Couch is 23, Eddie is 58, and I'm 7.
He's not wrong.
He's right about all of that.
Yes, and how we're going on a throwback here to one of the DLC quest videos. I can't remember which one it was. I think it was OG number 4, where we first went through the the dark space and what? What, you
think I'm too stupid to pull? Oh, he thinks he's calling us out, Dustin.
Oh God.
Morty, he's calling us out. I think we need to give him the scenes, Morty.
No, Rick. What are we supposed to do? We can't go to jail, Rick.
You're not on this video.
Aw.
Morty.
Lots of Rick and Morty references last night in our D&D campaign too.
Really? Oh, that's beautiful.
I think he said Scary Terry was someone from Rick and Morty. He was in there.
Okay. So
but you can't hide, bitch.
So, I just informed Chris that he is, in fact, not a ghoul, and he wanted to blow up all the ghouls.
Are you gonna let him?
Nah, I told him, let's be chill.
Do we have to, like, be diplomatic since we have an episode called Wasteland Diplomacy?
We have to be diplomatic?
Isn't that where we let people get slaughtered?
We have
ironically enough?
Yeah, Wasteland Diplomacy is murdering people. But...
Same.
Use your rebar club.
Oh, sweet, we have a hunting rifle.
Use your rebar club.
I'm not using a rebar club because I love myself.
Your rebar.
Do dragon rebar club.
And also because we don't have enough
dragon shout.
Melee.
Dexterity.
Melee. But yes. So.
Enough dragon shout. I like that.
The reason we're talking our way out of a lot of stuff is because, what is it?
We ain't no hollow back girls.
Yeah.
I'm straight.
Milkshakes bring all the boys to the yard.
Because, as you saw in Wasteland Diplomacy, where I died, like, got completely slaughtered several times,
did they see that? I thought we had
Whitney Houston, well, they saw me die, they just didn't see
it. Yeah, because that's when the Black Keys thing came up. Right, yeah. Sorry, go ahead.
They just didn't see the long trek back. Yeah. But, yeah, Whitney Houston is kind of like paper.
Don't you mean was Whitney Houston is dead? be respectful.
No, Whitney Houston's alive. Remember, we revived her, and now she's fine.
Yeah, that's true.
Or, you know, she got shot in the head, but now she's fine.
That's double true. Kill.
I wonder how many people are just really confused, because they've heard the name Whitney Houston before, and they know she's famous for something. Like, they may know she's dead, but they don't know our character's name is Whitney Houston.
Whitney Houston got shot by the terrible bullet called Overdose.
Damn.
That was...
That's fucking dark, dude.
Yeah. Quadra kill.
I mean, you know.
Still the Penta.
Shit, no, shit, no, shit, shit.
Mom, get the camera.
Penta kill.
Boone got it.
Damn it, Boone.
I'm...
You're one rad percent.
But Dustin,
I'm very close to dying.
Oh shit, you are.
My perception's at 2. Alright.
Dustin, it was like the 4th episode of DLC Quest where we're talking about we're home invaders, right?
Something like that.
Yeah. Well, anyway, I just remember I left this thought like halfway said, and if you're anything like me, and when people do that in videos, it irritates the hell out of me. So,
Do what? Invade homes?
Well, no, because I'm getting to that. Like, when they, like, get halfway through a thought, go off on a tangent, and don't continue that thought. Like, they get just enough information for you to get interested.
Yeah, but, and then never give you the rest of it?
Yes.
Alright, so thanks for watching Chattcast. Sorry, go ahead, Couch.
I can't, you've already ended it. But, yeah, we're actually invading Donald Trump's home right now, fun fact.
Sweet. Donald Trump can't handle this.
You know, we probably shouldn't make jokes like that, because if he wins the election, he'll,
If he wins the election, we're getting deported anyway.
I almost said export us instead of deport us.
I almost said imported.
Josh and I are on the same wavelength here.
If we're being honest,
that's scary.
I feel like... Eddie and I have had a conversation about this. If Donald Trump gets elected, anyone who's not an old, white, rich man cannot be richer than he is, though, is going to get deported.
So Bill Gates is getting deported.
Yeah, Bill Gates getting deported.
If Bill Gates gets deported, the country's over.
What if Steve Jobs gets deported?
They exhume his coffin and send it to, like, the Democratic Republic of the Congo.
God, I hope not.
I don't know why the Democratic Republic of the Congo, but that's just
they
what
can come
they
do.
Need an up. Trust me, after Kony, they need an up.
Kony in the Congo?
Yes.
You know, I talk a lot of crap, but I honestly think, you know, Trump isn't the worst candidate out there.
No, see, what my thoughts about Trump, I haven't really been, like, watching too much of, the, like, the political stuff, because I don't enjoy getting into politics too much, but,
yeah.
But...
we should do a talk show on campus after this.
Yes.
Yeah, sure.
I forgot this game doesn't have chat, and that's literally just, like, the command input.
Oh.
Probably won't use that, because I'm too lazy to figure out how that works.
Yeah.
We need to find the doctor, because...
Doctor, are you back in,
We're back in Novak now.
Oh, I don't know, I was thinking Good Springs.
Oh, good.
No, we're not in Good...
Yeah.
Okay, that's
Doctor is, like, off at the hut over there, isn't he?
Dr. Strauss just wanders around.
Dr. Strauss loves
you. Oh, hey.
I feel like...
You know...
Sorry. Go. Mine's unrelated to this.
Okay, so... I'll let you get back to that tangent
in
a second.
Yeah, no.
So you know that, that quest I mentioned that was terrible and we're not going to do it about the star bottle caps?
Oh, yeah, that one.
This guy is the second random encounter we need to get the full information on that quest.
I saw the word Festus in there and I saw fetus.
Festus is the magical genie of the Sunset Sarsaparillas, which is the soda that's not as good as Nuka-Cola.
Have you 100%ed this on 360, Dustin?
I 100%ed this game on 360. Got all the achievements.
I was going to be kind of concerned if you haven't yet.
Yeah. It was not easy, but, you know.
Yeah. But, how we're going on, like, the presidential
debate thing, yeah.
Sorry, usually I don't come back on tangents after this long, but my medicine is making me... Yeah, but anyway.
I understand, yes.
Yeah, the meth is a hell of a drug, but anyway.
And cut.
But I feel like Trump would be like the one person, no matter how terrible the things he says he's going to do, he would do all of them.
Every single one of them, yeah. Because Trump, we were saying, if Trump messes up, it doesn't matter because he has like $7,000, $7 million.
$7,000?
Yeah, that's a lot of money.
I'm a college student, that's a lot of money to me.
That's
an unrealistic amount of money.
I don't like spending over $5. Like, I hate buying food.
Yeah, I do, because I just feel like it's too much.
I hate buying food because it means another day of living.
Oh my gosh.
No, it's like when I buy food, I'm like, you know what? I wasn't that hungry after all. I could have waited a few more hours, hungry, snapped around a little bit, you know, waited till not eating the whole weekend so I wouldn't have had to pay for Croads.
Next week.
Yeah. Croads is the dining hall on our campus, by the way.
For all of you
None.
And enter.
For all of you people that have good food places.
Yeah, it's not.
Like picture, I don't know. Like picture a really nice Chinese buffet or something. Like a really nice one. Like I'm sure.
Imagine been turbulence.
Yes. Imagine.
I thought you were about to say imagine purgatory.
Same thing.
And that's a pretty good equivalent, actually. Imagine that being heaven, and then imagine purgatory. I mean, it's not the worst place.
We're slightly below purgatory. Yeah. Not quite hell, but it depends on the day.
We're like a purgatory that... I'm not going to say that. I almost said a purgatory Jewish people would complain about.
I love how you said you're not going to say it.
And then immediately said it.
But we can cut this later, guys.
You not know the motto of Chattcast? We don't edit.
Oh.
We do not edit.
We don't sync or anything. We just, like, we... put them into one video and then we should upload it.
How could you say that, Eddie? That's so mean, said Josh.
Oh, sweet. There's railway spikes and ammo.
Yeah. Did anyone else see that racist guy who just ran in here and said that? That was awful.
Said couch.
Josh, now I really can't edit that. Oh, okay. Yeah. It's cute that's auto run.
But no, Croads is terrible if you ever come to you. They completely took out
burgers from there.
Really?
Yeah. At least their shitty chicken, the shitty chicken sandwiches are now slightly better chicken.
Dustin, you are ratting it up, bro.
This isn't rad, this is limb damage because my head's crippled and I can't find the damn doctor.
So what's your head a limb?
Travel to Good Springs and go to that doctor.
You've got a good point.
Like I said, isn't the doctor that hut back there? Or is, I know someone's at that hut.
She wanders around is the thing.
Oh yeah, this is the one with the traveling doctor, shit.
Yeah, it's great, you know. Totally doesn't ever lead to situations literally just like this.
We could do Ben Hill music again.
Carry on my wayward son.
There'll be peace when...
Ow!
Mother Mary calls to me.
Can we just do like 5 seconds of like every song from
I'm gonna boss ass bitch, bitch, yes. Bitch,
so it's
bitch,
not copywritten.
Bitch, 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 I'm a boss ass bitch.
I think you could just stop after boss ass.
I'm a bitch ass boss. Boss. Yes, boss. I'm not a boss of anything.
I don't know. You're the boss of the videos you record.
No, I'm not.
There is Ezzy Pete.
There's Squeezy Cheesy.
I thought you were about to say Squeezy E.
There's 50 Cent.
Rip.
I wish Easy E had made like cheese brand called Squeezy E.
That could have happened if you would have killed Chug Knight.
That's almost as bad as my idea for M&M's drink beverage line, Lemon Lemonade.
That's great.
That's much better than what I just said.
Can we, trademark, these names real fast so if they ever want to do it, they'll have to pay us? Or at least we can let them do it, but we can get some royalties so we can get money because broke college students.
Let's trademark Lemon Lemonade.
There he is.
Easy Squeezy.
No, Squeezy E.
Squeezy E.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, that's not what I wanted to do. I need you to fix me.
Not dreads, but weird, kind of
dreads. I just want to point out...
What was his hair like?
It's like a Jerry Curl kind of...
Yeah, I was about to say, we could let the squeeze cheese could come out like that, and then squeeze the ease.
Oh, my God.
I just want to point out that, you know how I only had, three bars of health or whatever?
Now you're full health.
Yeah. Doc said, this isn't anything too bad when he healed me, so...
I mean, he did take a bullet out of your head.
That is true.
By nothing but doctors.
Doc Brown is pretty amazing. That's still not his name, but you know.
What if this is all just a hallucination of your last moments after you've gotten shot in the head?
That'd be upsetting.
Let's just call him Rick from now on. I feel like it's appropriate.
Is it that perhaps influenced from Rick and Morty?
No, it's clearly from
Bill and
Rick
Steve.
Springfield.
Bill and Steve, yes.
Or actually Bill and Ted's.
Yeah, Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure.
Cool.
I've never seen those movies. There's two of them out there.
Yeah, I haven't seen either one either.
No, Rusty and Marty.
Speaking of odd movies that I've never seen, there was only one Spaceballs, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's supposed to be a second one called Spaceballs 3, The Search for Spaceballs 2.
Yeah.
I didn't see that one.
That was never made.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's disappointing.
That's why he said that
they're supposed to be.
They're supposed
Eddie
to be.
Never listens to me, though. It's fine.
Yeah.
It's okay, Eddie.
So when are you going to finally evolve that Charmander? That you've had following you around for a little while.
Oh, that's true.
You mean Boone?
No, the one that's just always out of vision.
Yeah.
Oh.
The one that every time you turn, it's just always slightly out of vision.
Yeah. It's out of your field of view. Like, you wear glasses, so your peripheral vision isn't that great, and he's just right, in your peripheral.
I mean,
shoot him. Shoot him in the face.
I do wear glasses. Look at that.
Are we Whitney Houston?
Yes, we're Whitney Houston.
Why are you. Is it one of the mods where you can get cooler hair and shit like that?
Oh my god, he has a broad
Yeah,
eyes.
But that's one of those
He has Brock eyes. This is beautiful.
Yeah.
Closed.
The thing that I was going to say that I forgot what I was going to say. What was I going to say, Couch?
Probably something about Whitney Houston and glasses.
Oh yeah, the hair mod you were talking about was fucking the hair mod. Shit, my brain just went dead.
I could probably just Google hair mod.
There are like hair mods and like face mods and shit like that make it look not like potatoes.
Yeah, that's actually a really good way to describe it.
My computer is trash.
Well, I mean, it still looks better than the average New Vegas customization.
Yeah, because you know pink hair. Pink hair is hella.
All right, so what quest are we currently on?
We are currently on... We're still on the come fly with me. We need to get rocket fuel, and then we need to get, like, a radiation suit.
Is this
or
where
no, some kind of radioactive isotope or some shit.
Is this where we make everyone hate us and leave it on a cliffhanger?
Hold up. Will I fall off of this total cliff that isn't just, like, a rock? Tune in next
find out
month
on the next...
to find out.
Are we releasing these, like... Every month?
This is pretty much a monthly thing. Maybe we'll release the sequel soon, or maybe we won't.
Find out next
time. Every week to find out. Actually, this video is coming out in October, so we will have already started our double two videos a week upload, so tune in twice a week to find out.
This episode of Chattcast was brought to you by the letter C for the Charmander that is slightly out of the field of vision.
Thank you for tuning in. Have a wonderful evening.